The very word secrecy is repugnant in a free and open society.
Why are we getting these people put in office? Who's doing it behind the scenes? Who's promoting them? If you go back and you look at what Pike said in Morals and Dogma, what was he saying? He said it was going to take 3 world wars in order for them to realize their great work. And what was the great work that they wanted to do, Field? The great work they wanted to do was to create a planet under the authority of their sun god, Satan. They wanted our whole planet subjugated to their type of rule with their god. He was the head of the Masons. He was the guy that's trying to say, you know, anybody that doesn't think that Satan, Lucifer, is the head of Freemasonry doesn't understand. So you go up through all the ranks and it's about good and we're helping our children and we do all these wonderful things. What's the checkerboard all about? Black and white. We do good works and we do bad works, but we balance it out. And we meet in churches. Bullshit. They're doing the works of darkness. They're doing the works of Satan. If you're part of those organizations, you need to think again about what you're actually involved in and whether or not you're just a useful tool in Satan's plan, Satan's designs. The reality is, he, Pike, laid out this game plan, and what's been happening in the world ever since? We've been getting this continual march towards some kind of a cataclysmic, grand, seismic event that after which all the people of the world come under their subjugation because they all the governments are wiped out and they have a new government that's in charge of everything. That's not what we want. That's not what's right. And how much blood along that path to get there? Anybody that doesn't think that they've been successful in pulling this off as far as paying attention, the Illuminati, they're real. May 1st, 1776, they established their organization also. Just 2 months before we established ours as the United States, declared our independence. So these Illuminatus were hard at it. They were a little bit ahead of us in getting their organization going, and they infiltrated. They had people that agreed with and understood. And then a lot of our founding fathers, yes, they were in these organizations themselves. And over the course of time, through the Revolutionary War of England, and in the years after, many of them disavowed themselves of those relationships with the Masons and these organizations, these secret handshake clubs, not just the Masons, but the Illuminati themselves. Why? Because they came to understand that they weren't actually working in the best interests of America, that they did have other plans and ideals that were against the ideals of the American citizen and our independence and our own way of life. They repented of it. This is that moment when we need people to think again about what are you actually involved in? Who are you actually associated with? What are your ties? And choose